Welcome and thank you for subscribing to my list. I am Dr. Daphne Clarke-Hudson. I am a professional speaker. I'm an author of 7 books. I'm also a professional broadcaster, announcer, and live streamer, as well as a personal development and empowerment coach with a focus on building resilience. As promised, for your subscription, you would receive insider tips that will help you to define your passion and ignite your purpose. And for that, I have for you 21 tips. My intention is that you will find these tips useful and that they will guide you on your journey for a more abundant living. So now let's begin. Grab your pen and your paper or your recording device so you can record these, so you can have them at your fingertips as the need arises. Tip number 1, start each day with gratitude. Start each day with gratitude. It is very important because I am sure you can look around in your environment. How many people are always complaining of what they do not have instead of giving gratitude for what they do have? I want to assure you that the more you give gratitude for that which you have, no matter how small it might be, it will begin to multiply and to grow. So therefore, give gratitude and watch the multiplication that takes place. Tip number 2, clarify what you know your purpose to be. Clarify what you know your purpose to be. Too many people are running around saying, I'm trying to find my purpose. Let the truth be known. None of us, not me, not you, not the other person, none of us, our purpose has not been lost. We refuse to pay attention to it. We neglect it, and we continue to focus on somebody else's instead of our own. So I want you to grab your pad and paper, and I want you to define, write it down. Let it be as clear as daylight. This is what I know my purpose to be, and I am embracing it, and I'm going to give my full focus and attention to it. So that's number 2. Clarify what you know your purpose to be, not what somebody else tells you it is supposed to be. Not what somebody else tell you, oh, you know you should be doing this. What do you know your purpose to be? Now, step number 3. Once you have gotten the clarity of your purpose, you know what it is, you understand what it is, here is what I highly recommend that you do. I want you to own your voice in that space. Own your voice in that space. What do I mean by that? You live it, see it, taste it, smell it, speak it. Everywhere you go, you speak about what it is you are about. Let people know your message. So when they're going to speak to somebody else about you and your work, they too have clarity. And the only way they can have clarity is when you have clarity and you own your voice. In other words, once you own your voice, people will begin to look at you and they will say, oh, she is an expert. He is an expert in that area. And rightfully so, because you will be using your voice. You're going to be owning your voice in that space. There's nobody else in that space that will be able to speak about your purpose like you will be speaking. So own your voice in that space. Now, you know that you cannot do anything by yourself. At least, not anything that will be worthwhile paying attention to. And for that reason, my step number 4 is to encourage you to build a strong, powerful network, the best relationships that you can ever encounter and get involved in. I want you to begin to create and build powerful relationships. Powerful, active relationships. What do I mean by that? Relationships where it's a win-win for you. It's a win-win for the people that you're in the relationship with. You're not going to the table and say, give me, give me, give me, give me. But you are going to the table and you're saying, here is what I have come with. So in other words, you're all about adding what? Value. You are adding value. So when you add value, what's going to happen? You will be welcome at every table. You will be welcome at every table. People can't wait to see you turn up. And they're going to begin to tell other people about who you are. And the reason they can do that is because you turn up bringing great value and great gifts. So everybody wants to be in your company. All right? Step number 5, know your values. Hear me, know your values. If you don't know what you are about, if you don't know your values and your morals, you are going to be falling for anything. You are going to be falling for anything. So, make sure you put pen to paper and you list what your values are. On that list, you also need to note what are the things I will tolerate. What are the things I will come to a compromise about? Write it down, guys, because unless you write it down, do not just have it to memory. Because we need to write these things down so we can visit them regularly and speak about them. All right? I'm doing the same thing now. I have my notes here because it's 21 steps. I don't want to trust it to memory because I want to make sure I give you the cream of the crop. All right, step number 6. Get your community involved. And one of the ways to do that is to utilize local media. Local media. Speak at service organizations, Kiwanis, JC's, Lions Club, and other nonprofit organizations. You know, once you go to one of those meetings, the Rotary, International and all of those. Once you go to one of those meetings, they start to tell other chapters about who you are, and you begin to get invited. So what better way to get the community involved than to be presenting at service organization and to get a write-up in the local papers or even 5 minutes on the local channel? Or you can even start your own cable show, your own radio show. And that, I'm telling you, should you need some information on that, you can check me out at bit.ly/STRUGGLENNOT. So it's bit.ly/StruggleNot. That's one way you can get your community involved in helping you to define your purpose, define your passion, and ignite your purpose. Step number, where are we? 7. It is so important that you learn how to build momentum. Don't go gush, gush, gush right away. Easy does it. Easy does it, guys. Steady, steady, steady does it. Build momentum as you go along. This way you can enjoy the journey. Don't be in a rush. Enjoy each step of the way, every moment of the day. Enjoy it as you're on the journey. This way, as you're building momentum, you're also building a legacy pertaining to what it is that you are doing. So take a break, breathe, smile, and enjoy the journey. Too many people rush on the journey to get to the finish line, and when they get to the finish line, they're so tired that they are not able to enjoy the journey and even enjoy the success. So build momentum as you go on your journey, and take the time, guys, to smell the roses. Take the time to smell the roses. All right, step number 9. Visualize your end result. What are some things you are looking to accomplish once you reach those goals, once you manifest everything that's on your goal? What are some things you are looking to do? Is there a nonprofit you wanted to start? Is there a school you wanted to build? What is the end result? Visualize it from the beginning. Don't wait until you have all the dollars in the bank. You got to visualize it. You must see yourself putting the keys to open the door to go inside that building. So visualize it. Day and night, you must visualize it. People are going to be looking at you, and some of them are going to say, oh, you're crazy. But you know you're not crazy, because you know what you're working on. And you know you can see in the distance. You can see the end result. And when you see the end result, it encourages you to continue to work more diligent and to stay committed to that which you are visualizing. Tip number 10, adopt a habit of paying it forward. What do I mean by that? Help others. mentor others, be a buddy to others. Regardless of what kind of a business or career you're in, you can always, always, always find someone else that you can give a helping hand. So get into the habit of paying it forward. Because if you look back over your lives, we are all standing on the shoulders of so many people. We are standing on the shoulders of some amazing teachers and mentors. We are standing on the shoulders of our ancestors. So there's none of us, absolutely none of us, who made it this far all by ourselves. So a lot of times you'll probably read or hear about people who said, oh, I am a self-made millionaire. And I make a chuckle. And I said, the lies they tell. Oh, yes, the lies they tell. Because none of us, absolutely none of us, can make it by ourselves. So get into a habit of paying it forward. All right? Tip number 11. Take quiet time daily. What do you mean by that, Daphne? Simple. Be still. Be still. It is not a shame to sit down and listen to what's happening inside of you. It's not a shame. It's not a crime. You don't need to keep going 24/7, 365 days a year. Take time. Always have a pen handy and something to write on. Because in your quiet time, you will be surprised to see all of the revelations that's downloaded to you. You think I'm giving you good tips now? Begin to adopt quiet time into your life, and it is going to begin to rock your world like nothing you have ever seen. Isolate yourself out of the busy bee world that we are all in. Too many of us are busy, 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 and we are not accomplishing much. So, as you do your list for the days of activity, I want you to begin to carve out 30 minutes for quiet time. Not your lunchtime, 30 minutes that will be devoted to your quiet time. Tip number 12. Listen, there is something called journal. Yes, I said it. Journal. J-O-U-R-N-A-L. Do you remember that? I want for you to begin to journal. Gentlemen, I know many of you don't like it because you say it's too touchy, sensitive. Listen to me. I'm telling you guys from personal experience. As you begin to put your thoughts and ideas on paper, then the bank is going to fill up again. So, begin to journal everything about your life. You don't have to worry about grammar and punctuation and all of that. Just get busy and start to journal so that will help you to organize your thoughts. Many of the books I have written, portion of those books are also from my journal. So make sure that you are journaling. That's one good way of learning about who you are. And also, I want for you to remember to date and time each entry. And as you go through over the years, you're going to go back and you're going to see certain patterns that is coming up as you journal. Step number 13, or tip number 13. Your spiritual health is important. Your spiritual health is important. Quiet time is part of your spiritual health. However, what do you do in the mornings? Either before or after you do your journaling. Are you praying? Are you meditating? What are you doing? I don't want to really belabor that one because there are so many things available on the internet that if you do not know how to pray and how to meditate, there are so many programs online that you can adopt. Research them and go through them and see which ones tickle your fancy. Which ones tickle your fancy? However, I'm telling you, your spiritual health is very, very, very important. Don't get too religious that you lost the insight for you to utilize discernment and all of those. So that's something else that is going to help you a lot too when you journal. All right? Tip number 14. Physical health is also important. It doesn't matter it does not matter that we work on these big goals and then we sit down and we ignore our health and then we are not experiencing good health so that we can live our dream. It matters that we pay attention to this temple, this body that is entrusted to us. We need to pay attention to it. All right? Step number 15. I do, you do, and the rest of the world does. We possess a powerful tool that we leave dormant, and that's our intuition. I want you to learn to channel it, learn to use it, understand what it means, spend some time getting acquainted with your intuition so you know what to do with what's happening. The first thing I'm going to ask you to do is to be obedient and to surrender. Don't make the mistake like I made, where for years I ran away from that gifting of my intuitiveness. And it wasn't until God placed me in the hospital with a big surgery and speak to me and told me right there on the hospital bed that I can't keep running from what I'm called to do, that I totally surrendered. And now, unapologetically, unfiltered, I use my intuition. Not only is it a gift to me, it's a gift to my clients, it's a gift to my friends. And it's a gift to all of my supporters on my various platforms here on the internet. So, I want to challenge you to hone in, tap into your intuition and embrace it. Step number, 16? Utilize your creativity. We are all unique beings. No What makes you stand out? What makes you different from the rest of the world? In other words, what's your secret sauce? For me, I have a laughter that anybody would know my laughter from 50 miles away. I have a distinct laughter. I have an amazing personality. And there are so many other things about me that is special. Be creative in using those things. Don't be ashamed of any part of who you are. Every part of who you are is what makes you you. It's what makes you you. So be the best you can every time. So begin to utilize your creativity. And tip number 17, be innovative. Now you find out all the creativity, be innovative. What are you going to do with it? What are you going to do with it? Yeah, this is my story. I know my story inside out. However, you are not going to be telling your whole story to every audience you meet. You got to be innovative in knowing, all right, this part works for this audience while that part works for the other audience. So do the work, guys. Do the work to get to know you. Because once you define your passion and you ignite your purpose, there's absolutely nothing that's going to be able to stop you. Are you hearing me? Stop looking to your right and to your left about what others are doing. And just begin to look on the inside. And guess what? I want you to visit this more often. What is this, Daphne? This is a mirror. This is a mirror. I want for you to begin to visit the mirror more often so you can have a conversation with the person that is looking back at you in that mirror. All right, so step number 18, be a lifelong learner. Make sure every day you are learning at least 5 new things. 5 new things. You don't have to go to classroom. Because once you go through your front door, there's going to be lots and lots of lessons for you to learn. So make sure you learn at least 5 messages each and every day. Each and every day, I want for you to learn at least 5 new lessons. Lessons that will enhance your life. Lessons that will help you to define your purpose, define your passion, and ignite your purpose. All right? Step number 19. Hire a coach or a mentor. Yes, you do need that. I know you are well studied. I know you are well educated. I know you are well learned. However, you're not well versed on how to get you to stretch to maximum. So I want you to get a coach and a mentor who can help you to strive higher than where you are. Listen to me. Listen to me. Look around you. Look at all of the groups and organizations that you are part of. Are you the smartest one in the group? If so, it's time for you to exit. It's time for you to exit. Okay, so hire one of the best coaches. Yes, I did say hire, because you don't need to beg for time. You need to hire somebody that you pay to get the services. All right? Tip number 20, be part of a mastermind group. A mastermind group. Either join one or start one of your own that you invite the right people to be part of. And if you're not sure what a mastermind is, you can just go on Google and search about it. Those of us who are looking to strive bigger and to do bigger goals, we are part of mastermind groups. And that is very essential to your success. All right? And the last but not least is step number 21. I want for you to get involved in social media. Let me tell you something. With the effectiveness of social media now, we don't need to be doing business in our local area code, zip code anymore. We can be doing business all over the world. So, I pray that these 21 tips will help you. And let me just go them over again. Insider tips to define your passion and ignite your purpose are: step number one, start each day off and give gratitude. Step number two, clarify what you know your purpose to be. Tip number three, own your voice in the space. Tip number four, build powerful and active relationship. Tip number five, know your values and how it impact whatever it is that you are doing. Tip number six, get your community involved. Tip number seven, learn to build momentum as you are on the journey. This way you can enjoy the journey. Tip number eight, build a vision board. Ah, I think I missed that one. Tip number eight was build a vision board and use it as your blueprint. What the vision board does is that it guides, it gives you a visual image for going forward and what you are working on. So you're actually seeing your pictures of your result and your goal and your journey in words and pictures. So build a vision board. You see, when I say to write things down, it's a good thing I went back to look over this list, because I missed number eight. Number nine, visualize your end result and legacy. Number 10, adopt the habit of paying it forward. Number 11, take quiet time, at least 30 minutes a day. Number 12, journal. Number 13, spiritual health is important. Number 4, step 14, physical health. Pay attention to that. Tip number 15, we all possess intuition. Learn how to obey it and to use it for our advantage. And tip number 16, utilize your creativity. Use it and use your story as well so others will hear about your story. And tip number 17, be innovative. And tip number 18, learn something new each day. And tip number 19, hire a coach or a mentor. Tip number 20, be part of a mastermind group or create one if you can't find one close by to join. Create one and invite the people you want to be part of it to join. And last but not least, tip number 21, get involved in social media. This is Dr. Daphne Clarke-Hudson. I am a professional speaker. I am an author of 7 books. I'm also a professional broadcaster, announcer, and live streamer. I'm also a personal development and empowerment coach with an emphasis on transformation, reinvention, and resilience. I pray that these 21 tips to ignite, help you define your purpose and ignite your passion will help you do just that. And I look forward to hearing from you. You can also visit my website at DaphneClarkeHudsonEmpowers.com. DaphneClarkeHudsonEmpowers.com and connect with me on social media. Listen, success is theirs. Success is out there. It is ours to claim. Do not settle for mediocrity because you have the ability to create excellence. Thank you again for subscribing to my list. And I look forward to working with you in the near future. Bye now.